The answer is the first two of these do satisfy the correctness property. The third one does not. And to understand why, well, let's remember what the correctness property is. That's that for any message and any key, we have the property that when we encrypt the message with that key and decrypt it with the same key, we get the message back. And this is what we need for our encryption to be decryptable. We need these functions to be inverses. So for the first choice, the encryption function is M plus K. The decryption function takes that input, which is now called C, and subtracts K from it. Using the properties of arithmetic, well, this is indeed equal to M. For the second choice, the encryption function is the identity that gives us M back. Certainly, this does not provide the security properties we need. We haven't hidden anything about the message. And then the decryption function is also the identity. It takes in M, gives us M back. So this satisfies correctness, certainly does not satisfy security. The third property doesn't satisfy the correctness property. And the easy way to see that is to observe that the output of this is a smaller set than the number of messages. So there, for some choices of message and key, this maps to the same value. And an example of that would be if we choose K equals 2, if M equals 4, then the encryption of that message is equal to 0, because the remainder of dividing 4 by 2 is 0. But if we also choose the message 6, well, then the encryption with that same key of 6 is 0. Since two messages map to the same ciphertext, there's no way they could decrypt correctly. They can't both decrypt to different values because decryption is just a function. It takes that input. It's going to produce the same output in both cases. In this case, it's going to produce 0. It's not going to produce the message we need. So this is neither secure nor correct. But once it's not correct, we know it's not useful. The first one, as it is not secure, but it's actually pretty close to being secure. And if we combine the first one with a modulo operator and we never reuse keys, we'll end up with something that's perfectly secure. And that's what I'm going to talk about next. I'll introduce the first cipher that we'll talk about. And it's actually a cipher that is perfectly secure.